Morning, dear students. Today also we are going to discuss or we are going to continue with our chapter 2 from history part, from trade to territory. And in our last period we have discussed about Tipu Sultan, who was called as the Tiger of Mysore. He was called as a Tiger of Mysore because he was a very strong ruler, but he was also defeated by British and he was being killed while defending his capital Seringapatnam in 1799. He was ruling the Mysore region after his father Hyder Ali from 1782 to 1799, and in 1799 he was being killed by the British while fighting against the British or while defending his own capital Seringapatnam. And today we are going to discuss why Tipu Sultan is named as the Tiger of Mysore. Okay, so there is a big story behind that why he is considered as the Tiger of Mysore. So let's see why he is called as the Tiger of Mysore, why he is compared to a tiger. Okay, so actually what happened, the topic for today is the legend of Tipu, but that legend includes that story which named him the Tiger of Mysore. Okay, so everybody, not only the kings, actually we also have legendary stories, or we can say we also have some traditional story which we can consider as the historical event or historical story. So anyway, the kings are often surrounded by legend. The kings always have a story, traditional story of their own time, and their powers are glorified. Their powers are being appeared through folklore, which means traditional beliefs and customs. They also have had traditional beliefs and customs, means the rulers. Okay, so kings, they also had traditional story. They also have their glorified powers are being glorified through their folklore, or we can say a traditional belief or customs. So Tipu Sultan also had such a story. So here is a legend about Tipu Sultan, who was the ruler of Mysore from 1782 to 1799. So what is that story? So it is said that once he went to do hunting with one French friend. A friend from French was accompanied by him while going for hunting to a forest, where he had came across a tiger. So he met a tiger, or there he came face to face with a tiger. So at that time his gun was not working. Okay, he tried to kill the tiger with his gun, but that his gun was not working at that moment, and even he did not have his tools also. Like he always carry a dagger with him, but that dagger had fell to the ground while he saw the tiger. Okay, so his gun did not work and his dagger fell to the ground. Okay, and he battled with the tiger unarmed. So he fought with the tiger without any aid, without any tool, or without any kind of like a gun or maybe a dagger. He was fighting without all those, and he was able to manage or to get the dagger from the ground. So he somehow managed or picked up the dagger to kill the tiger. He fought with the tiger, he managed to pick up the dagger, he picked up the dagger and he killed the tiger finally. Okay, so he won the battle with the tiger, and that is the reason he is considered, or he is related, or he is related to a tiger. So he is named after that, is the Tiger of Mysore. So why he is considered as a Tiger of Mysore? Because he fought with the tiger unarmed and he was able to manage to kill the tiger. Okay, so that's why he was considered as the Tiger of Mysore. So he had the image of the tiger on his flag. So he's during his ruling time he made the image of the tiger on his flag to appear. Okay, because he fought with the tiger and he was the victorious for fighting with the battle with the tiger. Okay, this is the picture. You can just see where Tipu Sultan is fighting with the tiger, and this is a toy tiger which is being made. You can see, and this is also given in your textbook. This is the picture of a big mechanical toy that Tipu possessed. You can see a tiger mounting a European soldier. When its handle was turned, the toy tiger roared and the soldier shrugged. This toy tiger is now kept in the Victoria and Albert Museum in London. The British took it away when Tipu Sultan died, defending his capital, Seringapatnam, on 4th May 1799. But this was taken by the this idea was taken by the Britishers, okay, and this is the picture resembling the same thing, but here it is shown the British soldier. It is shown by, so this was taken by the Britishers after death of Tipu Sultan, but mainly this is related to Tipu Sultan, but that idea or that is taken by the Britishers later on. Then the company forces were defeated by Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan in several battles. The British company officials or British company, the Britishers mainly, they were defeated by Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan by several times. But in 1792, the Mysore ruler was Tipu Sultan. He was being attacked by combined forces of British along with Marathas and the Nizam of Hyderabad and the Britishers, means three, Nizam of the Hyderabad, then Marathas and the company, that is British company. They fought against the Tipu Sultan. They have started fighting with the Tipu Sultan, and then Tipu Sultan was forced to sign a treaty. Treaty means a document where you have to make some kinds of agreement. Okay, so Tipu was forced to sign that agreement with the British, and for that agreement they have taken two sons of Tipu Sultan, who was taken by one army general called Cornwallis. So Cornwallis have taken his two sons and for taken them as hostages. Hostages means person taken forcefully to secure the taker's demand, because they had a demand, and if that demand is not fulfilled, then his two sons will be kept with the Britishers. So that's why two sons were taken, so that he can fulfill the agreement which is being signed by Tipu Sultan. And if it is not signed by Tipu Sultan, sorry, if it is not fulfilled, that agreement is not fulfilled by Tipu Sultan, then they will keep his two sons as hostages for a longer period of time, or for maybe for lifelong. Then British painters always like painting scenes that show the triumph. Triumph means great victory or achievements of Britishers. When it is being shown in some of the pictures, they like that one, because their victory is being shown in that picture to represent their power. So here is also another picture which is showing the British power. They are taking the two sons of Tipu Sultan. So that picture also they liked, because their victory or their power is being resembling here, because Cornwallis, who is receiving the sons, two sons of Tipu Sultan in 1793 against a treaty which is signed by Tipu Sultan. Then Treaty of Seringapatnam, the treaty which was signed by Tipu Sultan. It is something about that treaty. So the Treaty of Seringapatnam, which is also called Sri Rangapatnam or Sri Rangapatna, signed in 18 March 1792, ended the Third Anglo-Mysore War. Its signatories include, along with the Tipu Sultan who signed the treaty, along with him, Cornwallis, who was the general of British, on behalf of British East India Company, then representative of Nizam of Hyderabad, and then the Maratha Empire, and Tipu Sultan, he was there while signing that treaty. So today we have learned why Tipu Sultan was being called as the Tiger of Mysore, because he fought with the tiger and he was able to manage to kill the tiger without any arm, unarmed. And then again we have learned that Britishers, they have forced Tipu Sultan to sign a treaty where that agreement has been there, and Tipu Sultan's two sons were taken as hostages, And British always like the paintings or any kind of things which are showing their or representing their power. So they like this picture also, which is given in your textbook, while Cornwallis was receiving the two sons of Tipu Sultan. Okay, so that's about a Treaty of Seringapatnam. You can just go through it, and then this is the the topic which we discussed today, and I will be giving you the homework through the WhatsApp. Okay, so thank you so much, students.